Hello, dear Famer, faculties and fellows. My name is Rudaina. I'm a clinical pharmacist at Hamad General Hospital. I'm presenting my project entitled Impact and Outcomes of Promoting Safe Medication Practices for Registered Nurses at Hamad General Hospital, the cardiology unit. Medication safety is a complex issue, especially in hospital environment with their complex mix of technological and human systems. Medication errors may occur when prescribing, preparing, or administering drugs with patient safety dependent on a variety of processes intended to ensure that they receive the appropriate treatment. Medication safety is important because medication errors are the most common type of medical errors and are associated with considerable healthcare expenses. This is based on the Committees of Identifying and Preventing Medication Errors 2007. The rationale of this project is that the global and national data are continued to show increasing sentinel events due to medication errors. Administration errors are one of the most serious and most common mistakes made by nurses. A study done in Hamad Medical Corporation concluded that estimated incidence of medication errors in this study as derived from medication error reports was as low as 0.04%. Almost all reports were submitted only by pharmacists for prescribing errors. This will indicate that there is likely underreporting about other types of medication errors, especially the administration errors, which are most critical to the patient care. The link of this project to health improvement is that reduction in medication errors will contribute to many health improvement indicators, such as links of hospital stay and cost, patient safety, employee satisfaction. The aim of this project is to assess the impact and outcomes of promoting safe medication practice. Some of the specific objectives to explore how nurses understand medication administration safety and the factors that contribute to or undermine safe practice during this process. Also to introduce and active sessions tailored to the needs of the participants and to measure the outcomes in terms of nursing sensitivity to potential error risk. The knowledge also to measure the knowledge gain regarding medication safety and safe culture concept. Design, the methodology of this project, the design is mixed qualitative and quantitative. Baseline assessment of the participants' knowledge and perceptions obtained using standardized validated questionnaire. Focus group discussion, which is semi-structured, to identify the needs and gaps will be held, followed by short interactive sessions to cover the gaps, if any. Post-intervention assessment will be done with the same standardized validated questionnaire. So these figures highlighted some of the important results. Here in the pie chart, we can show that most of the participants, 94%, were able to identify the correct role and responsibilities regarding medication administrations. When the participants ask about the barriers for good medication information knowledge, most of them, or nearly half of them, address that the workload and time restrictions. Regarding the perception regarding medication administration, they were asked how you think about safety when you are administering medication to a patient. The 41% of the participants were neutral to this. 33% answered that they are safe and confident when administering the medications. The possible causes for medication administration errors as per the participants, all of them 100% answer that the workload and time restrictions is one of the causes. 67% mentions the lapses and slips, which are human factors. Wrong ideas addressed by 33% of the respondent. 25% mentioned that intended violation could be a cause. Some of them mentioned that not following the protocols and the safe checks could be also cause for medication errors. So participants showed acceptable knowledge, 83% regarding error of commissions. But regarding the errors of omissions, only 16% were able to identify them. Nearly half of the participants could not able to recall or to admit exact error. The high workload and or time restrictions were mentioned by most of the participants as barriers to knowledge and causes for medication administration errors. A few participants, 8%, used to report the medication errors. The rest do not report the errors, especially when no adverse event occur. So in conclusion, the baseline assessment done for the participants redemonstrated the need for promoting safe medication practice as a unit, as many participants were unable to confirm whether medication errors addressed or not. Most of the participants do not use error reporting system, and this will reflect the false safe practice when the corporation performing the annual analysis. This result not included the full staff, which will be done in this month and will be followed by focus group discussion to further address the problem with its causes and consequences. Thank you.